shell, turtle power.
Hey, how's it going, guys? This is Dave2D, and this is a video on using external GPUs with the 2016 MacBook Pros. Now, when these laptops first launched, I was pretty excited about this connection because these laptops have nothing but Thunderbolt 3 connections, and these external GPUs have Thunderbolt 3 ports, so they should just work, right? Well, they don't. The first issue is that Apple currently prevents Thunderbolt 3 enclosures from communicating with the MacBook Pros. The second thing is that you need macOS to recognize that there's an external GPU in there, and by default, it doesn't. And then if you want to run this thing in bootcamp for Windows, the issue there is the allocation of PCIe bridges, all complicated stuff. But fortunately, some people have found some solutions to these issues. The thing is, before you kind of get into them, understand that there is an element of risk to this. I found that they're safe, I think that it's necessary to make this connection happen, so I did them, but kind of do this stuff at your own discretion, do it at your own risk. So first, you have to figure out which MacBook you're using and also whether or not you want to use it for macOS or use it for bootcamp Windows. You can make all of them work, it's just a matter of figuring out which one you want to use it for. I've linked a general guide down below, but if you want to get into it and you're actually interested in doing this for your own MacBook, I suggest you read into it and kind of figure out exactly the steps, because the biggest thing is that the process is going to change over time. As new devices come out, as software updates happen, the information that I would present in a video won't be accurate forever. So I've linked stuff below, kind of use that as a guide. Okay, so all of the 2016 MacBooks can be connected to Thunderbolt 3 enclosures. The easiest one to connect up is the 13-inch MacBook Pro without the Touch Bar. That one has the fewest number of tweaks to do. The 13-inch model with the Touch Bar needs a bit more work, and then the 15-inch model can also work, but they need some more tweaking because they have AMD cards in there, but they're all able to connect. In terms of enclosure options, we have a couple existing ones like the Razer Core, and we have a few that are coming out from Akitio, Bizen, and Asus to name a few. Now, before Thunderbolt 3 enclosures were all the rage, there were a handful of Thunderbolt 2 enclosures, and using the Apple Thunderbolt 2 to Thunderbolt 3 adapter, these still connect perfectly. And in fact, right now, the Thunderbolt 2 enclosures have better compatibility than any of the Thunderbolt 3 enclosures, which is kind of weird. They need fewer steps to get them working in either macOS or Windows. The downside to these Thunderbolt 2 enclosures is bandwidth. Thunderbolt 3 can handle 40 gigabits per second, Thunderbolt 2 can only handle 20 gigabits per second, so that's a pretty big difference in potential bandwidth. So I ran a bunch of benchmarks using different cards and different enclosures, and these are the results. The first thing to keep in mind right off the rip, you're not going to get the same kind of performance as a desktop PCIe slot. That connection will always be the fastest. When you put a card into a Thunderbolt 3 enclosure, you're getting a drop in performance of about 10%, maybe a bit more on some cards, kind of expected. We've seen this type of performance with Windows laptops and the Razer Core. The surprising thing to me was the performance on the Thunderbolt 2 enclosures. It's a further drop in performance because of the even tighter bandwidth restriction, but it's still pretty good. You're gonna get around 80 to 85% of the maximum performance of the card. And all of the tests were done with a monitor connected to an external GPU for maximum bandwidth. If you pipe data to the external GPU and then back to the laptop screen, you get a big performance drop. And the same thing applies if you want to use the 5K Thunderbolt 3 display from LG. Coming back through the cable hurts performance, so I really don't recommend it. So the things that do work. Most things work when you're running bootcamp in Windows. Everything from using CUDA cores for video editing to heavy gaming, it's all good. VR works nicely, and every video card that I tried had no issues. macOS is a different story. The GTX 10 series cards from Nvidia, like the GTX 1060 or 1080, those don't work there because there are no Mac drivers for the 10 series cards right now. You need to use the 900 series. Other things that don't work that well, some benchmarks don't work properly in macOS, and when you're using extended displays, it can be a little bit glitchy. So I preferred using mirrored displays, but everything else basically works. CUDA cores work in Premiere, and 3D games run nicely. If you want to see particular frame rates for a particular game using a particular video card or resolution, you're going to have to look them up individually, but in general, you're getting around 80% of the performance when you're using a Thunderbolt 2 enclosure, and about 90% of the performance of the card when you're using a Thunderbolt 3 enclosure. My recommended card, if you want something for both bootcamp Windows and macOS, the 980 Ti has come down a lot in price. If you want something for just bootcamp Windows, you can use the 10 series cards, but on a 13-inch MacBook Pro, because it only has two cores, putting a high-end card in there like a GTX 1080 can be wasteful if your games are more CPU dependent. I'd save the 1080 for a 15-inch MacBook Pro, but basically choose your card depending on what you plan on doing with it. One last thing, you need an active Thunderbolt 3 cable to make the Thunderbolt 3 enclosures work properly. They're often short, but they can be up to 2 meters in length, but just look for the Thunderbolt symbol. If the cable doesn't have this symbol, there's a very good chance it won't work, even if it's a super short cable. And that's basically it. External GPUs are viable on MacBooks. They work, and for the most part, they're pretty reliable. Now, they're not gonna have the same kind of performance as a regular desktop connection, and they're not the easiest things to set up, but if you're looking for an NVIDIA card for your MacBook, or if you just wanna amp up your gaming experience, now you can do it. That's the end of this video. Hope you guys liked it. Thumbs if you did, subs if you loved it. It's been nice. I'll see you guys next time.